India, other than China, India is the only other country which is always positive. Always positive, independent of, how gloomy the economic conditions may look like. But fact of the matter today is that, we are seeing a situation where Indians, especially wherever disposable incomes come into play, will bring down spends. This will have instantaneous, immediate, quarter-on-quarter effects on the industry. You will see reports and you will see, financial sheets getting weaker. Is it for a quarter, two quarters? I don't know. Is it for a year? Possibly. But please don't make any suboptimal call today just because of an instantaneous condition of today. Our structurals are very, very decently in place. Let me tell you that this is one industry, the QSR specifically, which responds, reacts the fastest to scale. The charts that you'll see here will show you that, the moment anybody who's scaled has actually moved up not only on capital employed, but has also moved equally well on what I would say as core profitability metrics like EBITDA. So, investing in scale, investing in a network is actually capital profitable. We've seen that happening abroad. We have started seeing a semblance of that happening in India, and we will see that this trend staying forward. Examples more than me, I think all of you know more of these examples. The way Sarvana Bhavan started off, took 10 years, got the first restaurant right, got warmer into southern India, did a little bit more outside of Tamil Nadu, and then suddenly going berserk abroad. The model, the scale up. Our stories, which are fairly exemplary. In the same way, you see a start or a sense of that happening in the case of Jumbo King. We have to be bold, but be extremely cautious of trade-offs. And the other thing I would really suggest after having worked with quite a few people in this space is, let me tell you, be objective. It is very easy. We've heard this from everybody since the morning, is the word passion. We are human beings at the end of the day, and passion should not, at any point in time, misguide decisions. We have to be extremely objective. I thought, live example was how we heard Mr. Singh call about, a five-year investment in a restaurant. At the end of the day, he shut it. It could be his passion, but at the end of the day, he was objective enough to understand, know, and analyze that this is the decision and this is what is right for the larger shareholder group. Being objective is something that I would be very, very, I would really propagate within this group. There are going to be trade-offs. There are going to be very, very hard decisions. The whole decision, we heard a lot about it, is, should I do it myself? Should we franchise out? There is a, you yourself manage this show. You are there at the in quotes, the galla, and you're seeing what's happening to your restaurant. Tomorrow, you don't know what's happening to four different places. Gives you a butterfly jumps in your tummy and says, I wonder how quality is being managed. I wonder how customers are being taken care of. But that is the mental mindset change that you have to bring in with professional managers, and making sure that professional managers are not just salary based, but are actually linked to the core of your business around service delivery. There is a big question which always, and I've tried to solve this objectively for multiple food service and food and grocery retailers in India, is the whole network effect. Should I have 12 restaurants in Nagpur? Is the potential really 20? Is it 50? Or should I go wider? I've got 6 here, 5 here, 4 here. There are, again, a set of very, very objective analyses. And believe me, we tend to underestimate the ability of India to give you data. Believe me, the government of India or some of the other places, you can actually get pin code wise data on what's happening in the country. Accuracy, well, we'll have to take it with a pinch of salt, but fact of the matter is that you can actually be very, very objective and very analytical about some of these decisions. We are changing every 5 years. The demographics is changing every 5 years. Requirements and needs are changing every 5 years. Cities are changing 5 years. Supply side is changing 5 years. Governments are changing 5 years. You have to change every 5 years. Please don't, recall your laurels and say, look, I did this 10 years back and it's worked for me. It may not. This is exactly the same problem that you're seeing in countries like Greece, who said that, things were great. Today, only to have a situation where a third of your population is dependent on government money and a third of your population is above the age of 60. So, please don't forget these macro trends. They are extremely important, can be critical, and can be, the definition of success and failure in this industry. Health is important. It is going to be more and more important. you will start seeing more and more of this playing out. Right from, and please take cues from what the packaged food industry is doing today. The packaged food industry has moved away from monosodium glutamate. They have moved away from, you know, you have all of them, you know, moving into declarations in a much, much faster fashion. I'm not saying that, you know, tobacco-like or alcohol-like regulations are going to come into this industry. But consumers, more than government, are going to drive transparency in this industry to be and be extremely sure about what they're consuming and how good is it from the short term and from the long term. Last point, please don't forget digital. Digital is going to be a primary strong influence. Right now, when I see this group, I can see at least 25 people who are still working on their phones because they don't find me interesting enough. Believe me, you know, the phone, the mobile phone, its applications, and all the other aspects related to digital are going to be very, very important. Today, from a very recent study that BCG has done, I can tell you, 22% of all youngsters in India, while of course, you know, rely a lot on friends' advocacy, are searching for a restaurant's name or on the basis of a location on the web, either using their phone or their home laptop, and finding out what is a good option. Please don't ignore digital. It is not a high investment channel, but it is extremely important from a high, you know, in the home channel. Please don't ignore blogs about, you know, your business. Those blogs are building public opinion, which is believed to be non-biased. So kindly, you know, these are extremely important macro trends. They are going to play out in some form or the other. Maybe, you know, maybe today, maybe over the next 2 years, or maybe over the next 7 or 10 years. But my suggestion to you would be to please keep these at the back of your mind whenever making calls about your business. Thank you.